वेलकम टू द ज्ञान निकेतन गर्ल्स स्कूल। मायसेल्फ तन्नु श्रीवास्तव एंड इन दिस वीडियो आई एम शेयरिंग द पाइथन स्टेटमेंट्स एंड द प्रोग्रामिंग। फर्स्ट वी सी द कमेंट्स। कमेंट्स आर द स्टेटमेंट्स दैट आर एडेड टू द प्रोग्राम विद द पर्पस ऑफ मेकिंग द कोड इजियर टू अंडरस्टैंड। Comments are the statements that are not executed by the interpreter and the compiler. That means it doesn't give any output. It is only for the user's convenience. There are two types of comments: single line comment and the multi line comment. Single line comments are using can be added using the hash character at the beginning of the statement. Multi-line comments is created using the delimiter. That means we have to use double quotes thrice in the beginning and at the ending of the statement. Using that we can add the comments. Now we will see the statements. Generally, programs are executed line by line, but sometimes we have to change the flow of execution according to the given condition. So control statement is used to change the flow of execution according to the need. There are different types of control statement. Sequential statements, where program are executed line by line, where statements are executed line by line. Conditional statement. Conditional statements in a program are executed according to the given condition. If the condition is true, then one set of a statement is executed, otherwise the other set of a statement is executed. When we use the conditional statement, there are two alternatives, true or false. There are different types of control statement. If statement is executed when only condition is true. If the condition is false, it will not give you any output. If else statement execute the true condition as well as the false condition. When the condition is true, different set of statement will be executed. When condition is false, another set of statement will be executed. It will give you the output in the true as well as false condition. If else is used to apply multiple condition in a program. When we are using if else, we can apply the condition with if and elif, but not with the else. Next is the iterative statements. These statements repeat a set of statements for a specific number of time to get a particular result. It repeats the set of statements to the given number of times. Now we will see the Python programming. First we see the sequential statement. In this program we can see int, input, enter, number. Int defines the data type. Input determines that we have to enter the value during the execution. And in the beginning, we are using two times opening brackets. So at the ending, we have to use twice closing bracket. Same for the b variable. And after that, product of two number is written within double quotes. It will be considered as message on the output screen. And after that, the product, you can see the output. Enter first number, enter second number, and after that the product. Now we will see the string operation. We know that we can perform two types of operation: string concatenation and string replication. So we have taken two string value. When we use a plus b, it will add the string. And when we use the asterisk sign, this sign is used to multiply the text with the given number of times. Suppose I have written a equal to a into 5, so the value of a is India. It is printing 5 times India. If you have to print your name, you have to use the same thing. Instead of India, you can write your name. Now we will see the conditional statement. Conditional statement, it is the example of if statement. That means it will give you answer only when the condition is true. If you will enter the negative number, it won't give you any output. It is the example of if else. That means it will give you answer true as well as false. N determines the data type, that means the integer value. Input, that means we have to enter the value during runtime. Now see the condition. A mod 2, we know that mod gives the remainder. If we get the remainder 0, that will be the even number. If we get the remainder 1, that will be the odd number. And double equal sign is used to compare the number. That's why we have used double equal. Don't use single equal for the comparison. That is single equal is the assignment operator. And in the output screen, you can see when you enter the even number, it will print even. When you enter the odd number, it will print the odd number. Now, this is the example of if else. That means apply the multiple condition in a program. When we apply multiple condition in a program, then only one set of statement will be executed according to the given condition. First we have taken the value, first number and the second number. And choice, that means according to the given choice, specific statement will be executed. If you enter the choice 1, then it will perform addition. If you choose 2, it will perform subtraction. If you enter the choice 3, it will print product of two numbers. So, and when you are writing the program, you keep remember that there should be no blank space. And when you will execute this program, look, first number and the second number, when I have entered 1, it is doing addition. In the second example, you can see first number, second number, when I have entered the 4, it is showing division. If you will enter the value, different value apart from 1, 2, 3, 4, it will give you invalid choice. Thank you.